ministry. In less than a year, I went to about 35 states. Now listen, I'm no more playing in America. Because you know, I'm all over the place now, man. Because every 3 days we jump on the plane. You know, and what was so amazing when I came to America, you know, we went home to Jacksonville. And the prophet said, I'm going to sleep in Arizona. I said, you're going to sleep with me. So I went to sleep in the room. When I woke up, I was sleeping on the floor. Most people don't see, that's what people see. They don't, he was sleeping on the floor. I was like, what are you doing? He's alive. I said, prophet, don't do stuff like that. Why are you trying to sleep on the floor? He does it all the time. When we go back to Jacksonville, we sleep on the floor. Wow. Began to jump. Doors began to open. Things began to happen. You know? And I began to see God. And I began to see why he is where he is. And while others are trying to figure out, you know, how to get to that place.
Yes.
Listen. And I think we're on Periscope now, right?
Yes.
So, you know, those of you on Periscope, guess what? We're in Ghana, Accra, live. This is the prayer mantle family, those who come in first. You know, some of you wanted to come to Ghana, the devil spoke to you and told you don't come. But guess what? I'm joking, by the way, don't get offended. But you know, there's a group of us here, you know, the first ever prayer mantle conference. We're just having our first meeting. Those who come in first, there's more coming in. So we're just spending time, just getting getting an understanding of where prayer mantle has come from, where prayer mantle is going, and what is going to become of prayer mantle. Some of you might just have to maybe catch a recording, whatever, just have to follow me through. You know, I said all of that to say this. Everything that I was going through, you know, Prophet Carn, I was in Jacksonville, and then he went to preach at a church, and he said, I'm going. He said, come and pray for this young man. He said, Albert. I said, brother, he wouldn't understand me. He said, Albert, go and pray for that young man. So I said, I went, prayed for him. He said, Albert, listen, you just need to just do what you're called to do, and that's it. And what he started doing was he said, Albert, whenever I'm going to preach somewhere, I want you to go in about an hour before me and just pray. Now, it's easy for me to do that in London because, you know, like my people, that type of they don't understand me. But I'm like, I'm in America. I think prophet, they won't understand me. Because now, just don't do it. So you know, most of the time the services, you know, we'll begin now, go and stand down, like, God bless you. I'm nervous. Then you know, but give me about 5-10 minutes.
Yeah.
I just go into prayer and I just forget about everybody. And the prayer will just go crazy. Like, God, thank you. That's how the prayer begins to start. You know, the brain begins to start to go, hey, you know, I can see the gift of God. Okay, so I'm not saying, hey, this is what I'm called to do. See, I ain't trying to be no prophet. You see what I'm saying? You need to know, you know, prophet, can I say, know your lane. Stay in there. So I'm okay, because my gift is prayer. Now, when I pray, and we were in North Carolina, I'll never forget. We pray so much that I just feel God talking about, you know, Pharaoh and letting the children of God, but I started praying about the male seed. No, knowing that there was a woman at the back, and I think I still got the note. Her son had been in prison. So she told me, she sent me a note saying that prayer that I prayed, she claimed it for her son. So the next month, when we went back to North Carolina, people were giving testimonies. She came out, you know, people came and said, prophet. I said, yeah, get out of there. So she came up and said, prophet. I said, this testimony is for you. People said, oh. Said it's for the African boy that travels with you. And she goes, my son was in prison. And he prayed a prayer last month. And I took that prayer and held on to it. My son, he was supposed to be in for years. She said, within, I think, a couple of days after that prayer, her son was released. Now that's a big testimony. But the thing that blew everybody's mind, she said, and guess what? He's standing right at the back of the service. So everybody turns, young man is standing there. Mm-hmm. You know, he's my churchy, so he's just standing there. I'm like, oh Jesus, this prayer thing works. You know, I'm my own worst critic, you know, because see, I've seen everything. I've seen people standing testifying in church. Mm-hmm. My God did this, God did that. And I'm like, listen, you know what they did that. And I'm not just, because I know the story. You don't know what, you know, I know whatever they've got, I know how they got it.
Yeah.
But that is the pastor. Mm. So, you know, when, what happens is when I was younger, when they, whenever they come and have meetings and stuff like that, and they leave me, I will check their feet. I just go and look at the paper, the note they've written. So, you know, I've seen it all. So I'm like, people coming to testify of stuff that's not God. You're trying to put God's name on it to make it look like. And it makes you feel bad. Because you now start wondering, why hasn't God come through for you? You know? So I've seen, so when the woman died, so now they receive on prayer mantle, whenever somebody notices, I say, listen, give me evidence. Like the lady who talked about when she was praying the prayer CD and the bullet came through. She sent the testimony, I said, please send me some pictures, I want to see. I mean, she sent out the picture. Anybody does, I said, Sister Mary. My time, Sister Mary, put a test on Sister Mary. Is it true? You go, probably it's true. I'm like, come on, Sister Mary. And like, are you sure this thing really happened? Because I've seen too much of stuff that's not God. People claim it to be God. So when God told me I went back to London, supposed to come back to America again, things didn't quite go according to plan. My God, what do I do? He said, how about prayer mantle? We started on the phone line, your periscope was in development. Started on the phone line, we had about 70 people. I was so excited. I'm like, Lord Jesus, thank you. I was 70, I'm so happy. So I was doing that in June last year. I was doing it every night. Now I'm working on American time. I'm in the UK, so, you know, because I just come from America, so I was still used to the American time. So during the night, when I'm supposed to be sleeping, that's when I pray. And during the day, I'm tired, so I'm trying to catch up on sleep. So I built this thing, just kept on doing it. Somebody told me about this app called Periscope way before it came. I said, I'm trying to use it. So prayer mantle was the first thing on Periscope. Went on there, got about 10, 15 people. I'm like, no, thank you, Jesus. Started using the Bible study. And as time began to develop because of the consistency and because of God, it just began to shoot up. God now says, put together this call to prayer. Bring my people back to the place to pray because I want you to teach them how to pray and how to talk to me. Because the Bible says he came unto his own and his own received him not. And that scripture says, you know, that's talking about the church. He came and said, hey, Mr. Preacher, Mr. Bishop. And the bishop said, yes. He said, you see that name that you call in the Bible all the time, Jesus? Yeah, that's me. Oh, can I come and talk to my people? And I'm the bishop. So that's my pulpit. Mm-hmm. You ain't come to my pulpit. That's my people. And I'm going to say, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. Say, God, say, help us. We develop idols. We've got preachers of LA, we've got preachers of whatever you want, we've got all these shows, and it glamorizes whatever the intent or whatever the reason why the show was first developed. I don't know. That is created such a mess. People rather sit down and watch these things rather than go to God and cry unto him and talk to him about what is going on. Talk to God about how, you know, the church. How messed up we are. People are still on TV watching who's driving the latest car, watching who's building the latest whatever. And the reason why we're really supposed to be here, we call the body of Christ. I said this before, when all of this stuff starts happening, all of these shootings, all of this stuff, please, can we all put our conferences aside? What is so difficult? I'm just thinking about 50 states in America. The churches come together, get the stadiums, say, hey, you people in California, all of you church, go to the stadium. You people in Texas, go to this place. And all we're going to do is we're going to bombard heaven with prayer.
Yes.
Nobody's having a conference in 2016. No. Nobody's having a conference. Everybody, we're just going to call on God. Because you know what? What is happening, what is taking place, cannot be the will of God. It is a death assignment. It is a death assignment. Because when Cain killed Abel, God said, hey, I hear the voice of your brother's blood. It's crying out to me, telling me what you have done to him. And I need to come and figure out how to rectify this blood situation. And the biggest revelation there is the Bible says, the ground has opened up its mouth to receive your brother's blood. And so now we know that the ground has a mouth. And we know that it gets hungry every now and again. And so every now and again, somebody needs to spill blood. There is no throne, there is no position on planet Earth which is vacant that you can sit on for free. Because even Jesus was seated, you know, for him to qualify to sit on the right hand side of the Father. He had to pay the ultimate price. I say, hey, listen, I know you're my son, but this chair ain't for free. You know, this chair ain't for free. You've got to go and spill some blood in order for you to qualify to come and sit here. But notice that when they, when he looked in all the air, I can't use Abraham's blood because he's full of sin. I can't use Jacob. He's full of sin. Then you can't use David. He's full of sin. Solomon ain't no better neither. He's full of sin. I can't use the disciples. I can't use the prophets because they're all full of sin. So whose blood can I use? It's a problem. Because there is a promise, you know, to pay, to sit on this throne. And so his father told him, the only way you can sit on this throne, you got to go sacrifice yourself. And so when the time came and the cup was before him, he said, Father, I want this throne, but he said, if it's possible, if there is such a thing in the realms of the spirit in heaven that can make it possible for this cup to pass me by, let it pass me so that somehow I can still sit on this throne. But he said, not my will, God. Not my will, sir. That's your will. Yes, Lord. God has to fight to redeem mankind. But let me tell you something. People think evil and all that kind of stuff only happens in this God. I would be the witch I would. I called the King Daddy. She taught me so much. Said, Albert, told me some places in California where they drink blood, where they do all kinds of nasty stuff. You know, she showed us, you know, vampires, all kinds, in America. Said, Albert, it happens right here, right in this nation. Because somebody is going to sit on this throne when Obama's time is up. In the UK, somebody is now fighting to sit on the Ricardo's throne. Let me tell you something. That throne in free. Blood has to be spilled for somebody to qualify to sit on that throne. Orlando, that's just nothing. There's going to be more. Because the next phase, the next season of this world requires a crazy person to come and sit on that throne. It requires somebody who just doesn't have no conviction to come and sit on that throne. We think we've seen the words of these people, but we ain't seen nothing yet. They're going to come into the churches too. They're going to come into the blow up churches. Because we become weak and we become caught up. Started, and we removed him from the throne, and we packed him somewhere, and we just bring out genders, you know, 7 points to your breakthrough, 7 points have to find a man, 7 points fake it till you make it, you can't go to these giants, and the people are suffering, and because you don't want the people to be free, you don't teach them
That's right.
How to talk to the one who makes us. You know,
yes.
I was driving the last time I checked. If you drive a Lexus and the Lexus breaks down, you don't take the Lexus to a BMW, place for them to fix it. All you gotta do is check your warranty, whatever it is, and take it back. Say, hey, Mr. Lexus people, you sold me this car. Now it looks like it's malfunctioning. Please solve this thing out. Sick in my body. Things ain't going well for me. How about I go to the person who made me? Say, hey, mister, you told me that before I was in my mother's womb, you knew me. So my starting point wasn't even when my mother and my father met. My starting point was even before they came into existence. So I can even bypass my mother and my father. Say, hey, mister, it's me. I got some issues. Can you tell me how to rectify what I'm dealing with, what I'm going through? Please, don't give up on me, God. Please, God, fight for me in this season. Fight for me. Imagine if I gave up. Imagine if I allowed people's opinions to get me down. Imagine if I just don't go, you know, you're crazy. You know, who are you? You know, you're nobody. Imagine. Bible says, despise small people. God is calling his people back to a place of prayer because he's tired. What is going on? There'll be churches all over the world today. Some will pray, some will touch him, some will do what he wants them to do. But there's going to be some who will perform gifts. Just like when Moses said, Father, if I have found favor,
oh God.
You know, maybe I speak to, I was trying to say this message or that I recorded. You know, Moses was a messed up man because he grew up in the palace. He saw all the things that, you know, the things that goes on in, you know, in Egyptology. He saw them. But then this being comes and tells him that, hey, can you go to this bunch of people and tell them that I'm coming to rescue them from this bondage? So, what's your name again? The last time I checked, that person that sits on that throne, his name is Pharaoh. And guess what? Pharaoh ain't no human being. Pharaoh is a god. And the last time I checked, if you are so powerful, how come your people have been enslaved for all of these years by this Pharaoh? You must not have no power. But I'm going to do nothing that you want me to do. God began to take him through a series of tests, show him some things to catch his eye. Moses sees all of this great stuff, and then he still makes this statement that bothers him. He said, God, if I have found favor in your sight, please show me now your way. You know why he said that? He's in all those other ways. The Bible says there's a way that seemeth right, but the end thereof. He's seen all of those ways, all those gimmicks, all the lies, tell the church, the prophecy that ain't no prophecy. He's seen them because he grew up in the in Pharaoh's house. He said, God, even all of this stuff that you've done, I'm having challenges believing that you are any different to this Pharaoh. So the Bible says, God said, you've asked me a hard question. But nonetheless, I need to show you who I really am. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to hide you in the cleft of the rock. See, God was caught up in a dilemma because Moses was a writer. You know, generalist people, they just write everything. if God allows Moses to see him forward, he's going to write about Jesus. So God says, okay, I'm going to have, because see, you can't see God and live, you die. But you're asking me a question and I need to show you. Guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to hide you, Moses, in the rock. Who is the rock? Jesus. I'm going to hide you in Jesus before time. Because if you mention that in Jesus, I'm in trouble. You're going to tell too much of my secret. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hide you in Jesus, and I'm going to walk past. When I come past, guess what you're going to do? You're not going to see me forward. All you're going to see is the back. And then you're going to take a pen, and you're going to go and write. Okay, let's do this now. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was without form and darkness. You're going to write all of that. You're going to write right up until the first five books. Because what you have seen is what I did. I need to read what I'm getting ready to do to a young man by the name of John. Because he's going to write, in the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. But Moses can only write in the beginning. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, God.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. He caught a glimpse of Jesus because he said, let us make man. Let us. But he couldn't put a name on that us. Because all he could see, God just gave him a small glimpse. Because had Moses called the name, he would have revealed the name in Genesis. And it was in time.
Oh,
that needs to be revealed. And God said, I'm hiding in this rock. Hiding. 2,000 years later, I'm giving you what is going to happen 2,000 years after you've left. Because this revelation is only reserved for that young man called John. John called the revelation because the Bible says that word that he used, the word, is the Greek word logos. And that's what you have, you know, you study biology, you know, the L-O-G-Y, you know, when the psychology. That word, it means the reason why. What John was saying was that in the beginning was the reason why. And the reason why was with God. And the reason why was God. He said, listen, the reason why you're here, the reason why I'm here, you make the connection to him, you will know the reason why you're on this planet. Not on this planet just to, you know, make up space and waste time. No, there is an assignment that you are not to complete. I don't care what you've been told. I don't care who's lying. I don't care who has spoken negative about you. I'm a living testimony. Oh, they will mock you. The last time I checked, He said to me, Albert, people say 1 + 1 = 2. And I like that mathematics. But when it comes to me, he said, for you to multiply and grow, you need to go through affliction. Because the Bible says, but the more they afflicted them,
come on.
I thought that would definitely come when they died, you know, because I'm tired, I'm going to die. Because, you know, I'm going through affliction, God.
Yes.
But the Bible says, not only did they multiply, but they grew. The more they afflict me, the more they talk about me, the more they laugh at me, that's when I'm going to rise up. That's when I'm going to grow stronger. That's when I'm going to grow more spiritual wings and muscles. Because all I stand here to say is, if those who laugh at us knew that a time will come when we would meet, not on periscope, but in person, it wouldn't happen. That's what they did. This is just the beginning. Oh, we're going to pack statements. Not because of numbers, but God just will do it just to show that he's God. We're going to go global. We're going to be all over the place. We're going to be what God has called us to be. And some of you, you know, you're like those spies that were sent out to go look at the land. But you're not going to be those who will come back with a bad report. Oh, you're here to see and to say that we are more than able. Yes. Prayer mantle is going to be more than able. Your ministries that God has given you, your assignments, is going to be more than able. I always say this. I say, listen, don't think that it's just about one person. Jennifer, you have your own assignment. You know, now, it can be tied to prayer mantle, it can be separate. But there is something that God wants you to do. Mom, there is something that God wants. There is something that God wants each and every person to do. Because that's what he is. It's not about one person. That's why he said, let us make man. Why didn't God just do it himself? He said, let us. Come. He said, come. Let us sit. Let us reason together. God loves doing things, you know, with God. God doesn't like isolation. Let's do this thing. Let's build this kingdom together. The Jennifer contacted me. Brother Apple. And I even spoke about the prayer. I said to you, you know, I said, I want to know more about this thing. And as the Jennifer, you know, I was walking. I was in London, Streatham, getting ready to catch a bus. And the school goes, and I will build a prayer center. I said, boy, I haven't been out of my own house. I still can't drive. What are you talking about? House. And you know how bad I wanted to forget it? I forgot it. But I said, God, when I go on the prayer line tonight, and you bring me to my remembrance, and I say it, and I'll know that you told me. So I'm on the prayer line. I'm getting ready to close. When it came into my mind, I thought, Lord Jesus. And if you listen to that recording, you say, and the Lord said, I should build a prayer center. So you now said it. And let me contact you. I heard what you said. I said, yeah. But she said, okay, so tell me about it. I said, I don't know nothing about no building. All I know is God told me to build. I don't know. She said, oh, but tell me. I said, well, you told me to build a prayer center. I'm going to be in Ghana. That's it. Okay. Another lady contacts me, goes out. I said, yes. I have an architect in Poland that I want him to help you bring this thing to life. I said, you people are wasting your time. That's what I'm saying in my head. I said, because I don't know nothing about nothing. So guess what? I prayed. I said, Lord, do me a favor. I see this Polish guy. Show him what you showed me. Because first of all, I can't even communicate because you know, his English ain't too good. So, guess what? I pray. He said, okay, I said, he said, okay. And he sent me some pictures. I look at those pictures. I'm like, God, I've never seen such a building. Never seen it. But I could see that this was what God had shown me, but I couldn't verbalize it because I'm not an artist. Put the structures down, put the plans down. I said, God, now what's the next step? God said, I'm going to build it, and it's going to be in Ghana. Listen, I'm going to be quiet, but I'm learning to be bold. See this book? My 36 years of living, everybody's failed me. The only person who hasn't failed me is this book. Nobody can compare to me. As long as I live by this book, the Bible says, you know, there's some scriptures that you claim as your own. It said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken. You see, begging bread. Never. It's not going to be easy. But I've never seen a day where God forsook me. People will ask me in America, you know, what's your connection with Brian Carr? Like, you know, how do you know? I said, I don't know. You asked him. You know, where did you meet him? I said, I just met him. He just said, I'm becoming trouble. People are mesmerized. Who's this guy you know, following? Who's this guy troubling? God is the one. Open the doors. Not because I want to do something, I want to pay some money. It is God. And I want you to understand that if we can trust Him and we can stay connected, just like what you did, you know, you have no idea what you just done. You know, just going against the grain. You could have used that money for something else. You could have bought, you know, a nice car, or you know, even just for a holiday, you know, to Orlando, you know, somewhere nice. But you decided to come to Ghana, Accra, where the lights go up when you feel like it, where you can't even get the tap water. But you obey the voice of God. I want you to make sure that you put some stuff on your mind, that you're asking God between now and the time when you leave. Make sure there are things that you have put in front of yourself. Say, God, I need to know the reason why you brought me here in the season. Mordecai said to Esther, don't think it's because you're pretty. Don't think it's because of the way you start preaching that place. Listen, salvation is going to come to us. The problem is, see, you can make sure that when the records are written, you'll be the vehicle that was used to bring out the salvation. Listen, the salvation is going to come. The three Hebrew boys said, listen, do whatever you want to do. I mean, kill us. But listen, just in case we die in this fire, let it be known by God. They said, let the record show that even when he fails, or even if he decides to not to come through, he's still God. Even if he says, listen, today I'm tired, I'm going to be sleeping, you know, I don't want to go and rescue these boys, they're bothering me. Even if he decides to do that, let the record show. He's still God. He doesn't have to rescue us. He's still God. What kind of faith will call us young men? Say, listen, take us into that fire. Bible said it was in the fire that the king said, hey, we put out anybody in there? There is one that looks like the Son of God. See, sometimes, and I learned this week, God needs to teach the fire that there are some people that you can't burn. God needs to teach that story, Mr. Jennifer, that there are some people you can't take out. God needs to teach, not you, but the situation. Normally cancer kicks people out. But you know what? I'm going to make this person live with cancer in their body, but they will still live and not die. Because there are some people that I need to use as my example. Prophet Carn, we were in Jacksonville. I met a woman, powerful woman of God. If you come into contact with me and you have the Holy Ghost, you will know you've got it. She was sick. She went to the hospital. And the doctor was trying to act all, you know, sophisticated. You know, she was a Holy Ghost filled woman, so she went there. She was speaking in tongues. The doctor made a comment and said, hey, why are you here? She said, oh, you know, I'm here because, you know, do your test, whatever. So the results came back. The doctor told her what she had. She said, I don't believe in this lie. That's not, you know, she said, you know, that's not God. So the doctor said, so why did you come to me for? He said, well, you know what? All I came to you for was to get the name the lie.
The name.
Jesus. See, because see, it's very easy to just pray general prayers. But if I know that the name of this lie is called, I don't know, maybe awesome, I can go into my prayer closet and I can target my prayer and say, awesome, spirit of awesome, come out of my mouth.
Yes.
I shout out that doctor in no time. I just came to get the name of that lie. What is the lie that the enemy has been speaking to us? What is the lie? Some of you, you know, you were traveling here, the enemy told you that you're crazy. You know, God, what is in God? People can't even pronounce the name properly. God, what is it? God? What is in that place? What is here? Why are you going there? You know, Africa. You know, it's the dark continent. Whatever it is, you know. Reading up on God and it's flooded, you know, all that kind of stuff. You know, the enemy will bring all of this stuff before you, make you feel like you're crazy. But I always say this, when the Son of God needed a place to hide, so that the enemy will not have him. God looked at his whole creation and said, hey, take him to Egypt. Take him to Africa and hide him. And I always say this, the reason why this continent has been in such a mess, because the devil is still mad at Africa for keeping the Son of God alive. That's my revelation. I didn't hear that from nobody. Because the enemy killed every other baby boy under the age, 3 years and younger. But for some reason, couldn't get his hands on the one that he wanted. And since that time up until now, the enemy said, I'm going to make sure that Africa never rises. Because of what he did to me. We're here today to begin the process of returning this continent. See, God don't need a whole bunch of big people to return these people back to the original intent of God. The first superpower we introduced in the Bible, the dynasty or a superpower country called Egypt. That's the first superpower. Just go through the Bible. By the time we get to the New Testament, it's the Roman Empire. God wants to raise up. The Bible says, because your foot has stepped in this place, whatever connections that you need to have for you to get to that place that you need to get to, if you can just open yourself up and say, Father, into your hands. Met my life. Yes, Lord. The process will begin here. You will go to America. You will go to London, England. And you will begin to see what you've never seen before. Because you have been obedient to the voice of the true living God. Let's be arising, please. Everybody just stand. Everybody just stand. Let us begin to worship the name of the Lord. Let us begin to thank Him. It is by His purpose and His divine assignment that we made it to this place. In the name of Jesus, begin to open up your mouth and praise Him. Yes, Lord. Power and might belongs to Him. You have come to this place for such a time as this. There is an Esther waiting for you to come out. There is a vision that needs to be grasped. There is a people that are waiting on you to manifest. There is a cry on the inside that needs to come out. In the name of Jesus. Victory belongs to us. Victory belongs to the children of God. There is nobody like our God. There is nobody who can heal. There is nobody who can deliver. There is nobody who can set us free. But that name, that there is no competition and there is no competitor, that is the name that we stand on. The name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God, thank you for Acurra, God. Thank you that God, you've chosen this place and you've chosen this people to represent your family, God, that you birthed in the name of Jesus, God. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Alabas. In the mighty name of Jesus, God. Hallelujah. Father, power and might belongs to you, God. In the name of Jesus, arise, O God. Demonstrate your strength. Demonstrate your power. In the mighty name of Jesus. 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 Alaba Sukurosha. Masipe Kalabandi Libyasa. Jesus is Lord. In the name of Jesus, Father God. Let the voice of every overtaker, God, who has tried to overtake your people in the sea, let their mouths, Father God, Let their feet bow. Let whatever they are using to try to overtake your people, let it be dismissed in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Victory belongs to us. Victory belongs to us. Victory belongs to us. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father God. The other day, God, they met in the upper room, the Holy Ghost. He didn't come because they had a big convention. The Holy Ghost didn't come because they had big names. The Holy Ghost didn't come because it was a denomination. But Father, when your people, God, sacrificed their own agenda and began to call upon your name and began to lift up your name, Father, your presence, God, it began to fall in the name of Jesus. Let the presence of God fall. Let the presence of God fall. Let the power of God fall. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Give me clean hands this hour. Give me a clean vessel. In the name of Jesus, God. Jesus. Give me a clean vessel this hour, God, to push your people, God, into their destiny and purpose. Give it to us, God, as we need it in Jesus' name. Show us the way, God. It is well, because Father, you said so. It is well, because you said so. It is well because you said so. It is well because you said so. It is well because you said so. In the name of Jesus, God. Father, you have to come to Father. Father, to take this bread and back to I'm a fool of all of us. It shall be broken in Jesus' name. Father, this bread will be broken in God. God, this yoke will be destroyed in God. In the name of Jesus. I'm sure. It will be broken in God. That's why she came to God. That's why she's in a cross. In the name of Jesus. Jesus is Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. This will be the place where she will go through a rebirth. This will be the place that she will go through a rebirth. This will be the place that she will go through a rebirth. In the name of Jesus. There is a battle that comes from Alabasha. Hey, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Hey, Jesus. Ha, Jesus. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 To reveal your purpose into her life. God, by reason of the blood that is flowing through her. God, I change her blood flow into God. Yes, Lord. The blood that was shed on Calvary. The blood that came through the veins of Jesus. God, we change her blood type. We change and we modify what the enemy wants to put into her system. Jesus. Acurra, God. Do what you said you would do, Father God. A call to prayer, God. These are your people. I have no power, God. I have no authority. But the authority that has been given to the sons of God. Father, she will not leave Acurra herself. The weight that she's carrying, every excess baggage that she's carrying, every excess weight that she's carrying, God, it will fall off in Jesus' name, in the realms of the spirit. Every yoke, that's the word I'm looking for, every yoke be a flaw, every yoke, because the yoke breaking anointing, God, is in this place, God, to break. That I'm talking about, God. Yes, Lord. I'm your voice, God. Please, God, give her victory. Give her victory. Give her victory. In Jesus' mighty name, victory belongs to her, God. I take that victory for her. I take that victory for her. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, we bless this name. Because, Father, at the mention of your name, God, the last time I checked, everything in creation bows down at the mention of your name. At the mention of your name, God, everything bows down. So God, the last time I checked, victory belongs to you, God. Whatever has the audacity to stand in this place, that is not you. Father, break your legs in Jesus' name. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you. Holy Ghost. Thank you, 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 Holy Ghost. Let the yoke be broken. Let the anointing be strong, God. Increase it. In Jesus' name. I'm talking about God. No flesh will glory in your presence. Your prayer mantle, God, is not about any person. It's about you, God. Jesus. You stand out of the way, God. We're tired of flesh. Tired of people telling us what they do. We're tired of all the lies, God, coming from the pulpit. Father, I ask you to take your place, God. In the name of Jesus, child, Lord. Father God, mom, see your glory, God. She will share your glory with us, God. Father, keep her in perfect peace. Let her mind be small. Let her strength, God. In the name of Jesus, God, the enemies will have nothing to do with her sins. Her children will prosper. Her life will be a blessing. She will continuously be a testimony. Lord Jesus, God. God, I receive the promise. She has a faithful family. Receive the God. But she wants me to encourage me. What she wants for me to have. Because sorry, she says, silver and gold have I not. But such as I have, I give unto you, young man. Yes, Lord, I receive it. Shake the dust of your feet. Yes, Lord God. Wherever she's been to that God, she's not been accepted. Father, we shake this dust of her feet in Jesus' name. We clean her up, God. Yes, Lord. We position her back to that place of greatness. Her star will never be dimmed. Her star, yes, Lord, never be dimmed, God. I said, her star will never be hit, God. In Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, God. In the name of Jesus, God. Father God. Yes, Lord God. Father, the warfare intensifies, God. When the breakthrough and Father God, the frustration of the wicked one comes, cannot reach your vessel, God. Father, you know, Heavenly. The enemy might think that the enemy knows it, but God, that is not the case. Father, the eyes which have been opened up, Heavenly God, are closed and are blind, the third eye, in Jesus' name. The power in the third eye are nullified. I shut it down. Break those legs of the enemy that have been following him. Yes, Lord God, the movements of the demonic realm against her life, God, it shall come to an end in Jesus' name. She will not live the life of somebody else. She will not be an imposter, God. She will be the vessel that you call her to be. I remove her destiny from the realms of darkness. I command every burial which has taken place on her behalf in the name of Jesus. We cancel every funeral service on her behalf, God, every sacrifice of the bloodline, God. Because we know that there is a new bloodline.
Yes, right.
And the blood of Jesus. That is the blood that flows through her mouth in the crown of her head. All of her feet, God. So shall it be. In Jesus' name. We bless that name, God. We thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you,
in Jesus' name. Thank you, Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Is there anything too hard for you? Thank you, God. Jesus mighty name. Hallelujah. 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 In Jesus mighty name. Amen. God bless you. Thank you so much. In Jesus mighty name. In Jesus mighty name. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. In Jesus mighty name, God. In Jesus' mighty name, we lift up that name, God. We thank you for your assistance. We thank you for your help, God. In the name of Jesus, Father God, I pray that God, oh God, this vessel, God, that just likes to help, God. Father, in the name of Jesus, every need shall be met in Jesus' name. God, this is no coincidence, nor is it an accident. But Father, it is because you have counsel and Father God, you have purpose that needs to be birthed from the inside. I push him into destiny. I push him into purpose. In Jesus' precious name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah, God. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, I thank you, God. Yes, Lord God. Your will and your counsel shall stand. Yes. Test of time. Yes. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. All of us. Father, we count every single vessel in this place with your precious blood. Father, we thank you that God, you showed up in this first meeting. We thank you that God, you didn't forsake us. That God, you showed up in the precious name of Jesus. We thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. If you can, you can take your seat. If you can, you can pray last night. If you can. God bless you. Periscope family, God bless you. I hope you had a blessed time. God bless you. Thank you so much for your support. Thank you for the vision and those who participated and helped to pray. push and to bring this vision into manifestation. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. God bless you, Periscope family. Goodbye. Have a blessed day. I'll come back and talk to you later. God bless you. Goodbye. Jesus. Yes, Lord.